Yeah, that's a bad one. That's a big yikes. Wait. Did Vats make us invulnerable? Oh my... God damn it! We got done by the flames! He seems to be... Okay. Please, can we take advantages? I don't know what everyone else is doing, but if he can stay glitched like this, I'm happy. No, 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 don't. I see you there, you prick. No, I can see you. Oh my god. I can see you. We got him. We got him. It only took the whole damn thing absolutely glitching the hell out. Mudcrab will fight, yes. Yes, they are actually fighting. Yes, fight the mudcrabs. I am not your real enemy, the mudcrab is. Okay, this is leveling up exceptionally slowly, which I should have predicted considering how low level this stuff is. Wait, you know what? We should use this. This is actually like a... Why did I even try that? You know what they say about people with big shoes? Big feet. You know what they say about people with big feet? Big pen... Wait. Big glove? No, that's hands. Wait, hold on. She swallowed the spider to catch the fly! Ha ha! I don't know why she swallowed the fly, but it's bloody working for her! Ha ha! Chonk, chonk, my friends! I am the smartest man alive! Look, this boy! Yeah, buddy! I did this. I did. Ooh, what is this stuff? Just trying to jinx it, you know? Why is that bush so solid? Apparently, that bush just blocks all of my bullets. Damn you, solid bush! You've heard of solid snake? Well, here's solid bush! Now, look at that galaxy burning. And those cold, dead eyes. There is nothing inside of those papers. There is nothing beyond the veil. It is the void and nothing else. That is the man you want in charge. That is the man you want vanguarding the safety of your whole society. We made the right choice.
Hello there.
Strange.
Yep. Here they are again. They're back. Okay, let's get those Overwatch shots. Come on. One hit. The snipers. Hoo-ho-ho! A thing of beauty. The snipers unite. This is exactly why we like Colonel snipers, but we hate Dick Simmons. God damn it, Dick. Wow. Someone is going to sleep so well.
One down, my friend. One down.
Error tiré base of flight près de Toulouse sans time. Drink up.
You did this.
Yeah.
guys. Sorry to do this straight away, but somebody has asked for something literally as I'm going live, so I will have to be... I should only take like a minute or so, but I'm just gonna have to go back to the BRB screen, so hang tight.
That's funny, I freaking thought I clicked the go live button and apparently I had clicked the start recording button and stuff.
Oh, so you haven't been live that whole
time. I'm like trying to pull it up on my phone and I'm like, where the hell is my
screen
not going
up? Why is nobody in chat?
Yeah, what's going on?
Come on, guys.
He's good. We're lucky to have him.
I'm already in the Do you have to invite me, or how does that work?
Probably.
I just clicked play online, so it's signing me in.
Oh, that was a choice voice line, Adam. Choice timing. What are all these different trees? Boreal pine. Oh. What's the difference? Content creator trees and normal trees. Do these trees create content? Alright, this one right here. Take two?
What? They took it from Joffrey? Things are worse than I had thought.
They did. Can't even believe it. I can't even believe it. How could they do that to Joffrey? Hey everyone, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. That's how I feel right now. I hope everyone's doing good. Welcome, Sean. Welcome, Omega. How you doing? Indie time. It is. However, it's not the indie we were hoping for, because I found out an hour before going live that the code that they'd given me ran out, basically. It was a timed one, which I had no idea about. I guess it was, I think it must have been timed with Steam Fest, which I didn't really know anything about in general, let alone that this one was specifically part of that. So unfortunately, we're not going to be playing Battle Shapers. We're going to be doing some House Flipper again. We could have played something else, but I didn't have any time to think about it. I just wanted to relax and paint a house a dumb color. So we're going to be playing some House Flipper. Hopefully that's all right with everyone. If not, it's my stream. I do what I want. It's been forever since I've watched an Isaac stream. It has been a while, Short. I hope you've been well. Also, very good response from Marvin there. Classic. Classic response. Hydration, let me get that hydration. Thank you for that. Sleepy? Yeah, I feel you. I just was out with my daughter, my wife and my daughter at a, at like a winter lights festival thing, which was actually pretty cool. It was better, a lot better than I thought it was going to be. And I just hadn't, I sort of woke up fairly early this morning and stuff, just kind of exhausted, a lot of walking, and then this whole schmozzle with the game that I was supposed to be playing, just being super disappointed by that. But we're gonna pick up, we're gonna paint a house of something stupid, and we're gonna go to the moon eventually. I don't know if we can make it before then, but we'll see what happens, like in the time of the stream anyway. We'll see how far we get. Next Fest, is that what it was? That sounds about right. Next Fest sounds right. It was something on Steam. There was like a bunch of indie developers or something, I think. Yeah, showing off their games, something like that. And I sort of heard about it in passing, but I didn't really, I mean, the thing was, we already had a bunch of games lined up over the period of that time anyway, at least the slot that we use for indie titles, so... I never really saw much about it. Yeah, Drongo did get into it. Yeah. That's basically the only reason I really knew much about it, that it was even happening and what was going on. And even then, I didn't really know much. But I didn't... When I applied for the key for this game, I didn't hear anything about that festival specifically in any of the conversation that I had. And when I requested it, I was like, this is exactly when I will... this is exactly when I will have time to do the game. And then they were like, yeah, have the key. So I was like, okay, well, we should be good then. But obviously, they didn't read all of it, I guess. And they gave it to me anyway, and then I didn't get to play it, which is quite a shame. Hey, Crips, sorry, I was just getting that message, that explanation out of the way. How you doing? Late because you were practicing Brawlhalla. Good, good, good. Ranked 2 in a tourney? Was that versus the bots or an online one? All I can say is imagine that it's cold. It was kind of cold. It rained a couple times, but not too much. And we actually got to see it all fairly well. It timed itself relatively well. And we all had, you know, some big jackets on. So it was actually not too bad. Honestly, not too bad. I think I got my bindings figured out. AI, but damn, it was hard in the end. Yeah, so I played it a bit today. First time I'd ever played it. I think my Steam account says I've played it for about an hour and a half. So, like, an hour and 15 minutes, because a lot of it was... well, not a lot of it. Some of it was just, like, making sure it was all going to work properly and everything. I played a few different characters. And damn, there's some of those characters that are just, like, super difficult to use. And I was just trying through a few of them. And the first one I tried, I hated. And then the second one I tried, I was like, oh yeah, this is pretty damn good. This could be my character. And then the third one I tried was awful again. And then the fourth character I tried, I'm like, holy crap, this is even better than the second one, the one that I actually liked. This is my character. And I was just like, I was popping off with that character somehow. I think because I've played a lot of, I'd played a decent amount of Super Smash Bros. Before, and the style in which this character controlled felt like a bit like Link, which is like my main character in Smash Bros. So I was just sort of popping off compared to the other characters that I'd played. So yeah, I was it's gonna be interesting. I'm really looking forward to hopefully a couple people getting involved, because I'd really like to not only have like a proper tournament going on, but I'd love to give away a bunch of games. We've got like over 50 games to give away, so that's going to be one of the slots where we're going to give away a decent chunk of them, because we're going to have several tournaments within the space of 2 hours. Everyone that wins each of those tournaments, each winner of all of those tournaments will get a free game, and then the winner overall will get 3, the second place will get 2, and the third place will get 1. So it's a whole thing. I'm looking forward to it. Lost because one of the AIs was stupid OP. Some of them are pretty hectic. They just get you in stun locks. I was playing one of them where I was just like, I just couldn't break the cycle. Like every time I tried a different move, they always just manage to time it perfectly in the gap and stop my attack. Oh, so frustrating. Found the best with melee mains. Oh yeah, I suck at ranged mains. The one I use is a melee, but it's got like it's got a fairly long reach range, fairly long reach melee. What I'm saying. So it works out to be a lot better for me. Too tired? Good night. Oh, Omega, no. Go to bed. If you need sleep, go to bed. Thanks for stopping in. I hope you had a good 10 minutes. And hopefully catch you again soon. Beyond the tournament, I was number 1 in the first, second rounds, but bottled it in the third. Yeah, fair enough. Yeah, I deliberately don't want to practice too much because I don't want to come in. I don't want to come in and just like, I mean, this is going to sound really arrogant, but I have a bit more time to practice if I wanted to, and I don't want to come in and just dominate. because that just wouldn't really be fun for anyone. So I gotta do my best, and I've practiced for an hour and a half, and that's all, well, close to an hour really, and that's all I'm gonna practice. And I'm hoping that it'll be fierce competition when we get to the moment. I'm best with Nash. That's what I used to rank 2 in the finals. Nash, which one was he? I'm trying to remember. I didn't really pay attention to what everyone else was using. I only paid attention to the couple that I played, which were seemed to be doing pretty well. I got a bunch of characters unlocked from Twitch unlocks. Oh, nice. Extra skins and such. Nice. I'll be interested to see those. Because I've just got like the basic, I want to say, 8 characters, maybe 10. Not focused on getting in the giveaway. I just want to be an absolute menace. Look, that's that sounds good to me. Just have fun. Just be a troll, have fun. Just enjoy yourself. That's what we want. Cause yeah, I'm not sure if you can add bots in. I'm hoping that I don't have to add bots in, but I'm not optimistic that we're gonna have enough people to fill out like all of the tournaments. Yeah, I don't know. We'll see what happens. You want to win the Call of Juarez, get keys for yourself? Yeah, fair enough. They're pretty decent games. So when I clarified in the thing, I almost said that myself and Adam won't be allowed to have the keys. But then I was like, nah, that's not really fair, because although usually he says he'll give the keys to other people and he doesn't really want the keys, I know that there probably are some keys in this bundle that he actually wouldn't mind. So I'll let him decide whether he's in or out. And yeah, if you want to put your name down for any of those keys, you're like 100% welcome to. So it's gonna be a fun time. Oh, my hair! What is going on with my hair? God damn it! Why? Hey, Aaron, how you doing? Welcome. It's going, I don't know. I was supposed to be playing a new game tonight, and turns out the code that I was given was a demo one that was only for a certain period of time, and I wasn't aware of that, and it ran out. And so I wasn't able to play it tonight. And we've shifted to House Flipper, which I will start soon, just because I want to relax and paint dumb stuff, or do dumb things, so we'll see. We'll see how we go. My key bindings are kind of odd though. It's the basic WSAD for movement, space is jump, Q is dash, R is drop, JK are my attack binds. Wow! I mean, it's a bit weird, but it's not that wild. Like, it's not like untenable. Like, the default ones work fine for me, but the thing that always gets me in the game at the moment is because I'm so used to Smash, not having a block, only having like just a dash is something to get used to. Don't use the mouse. Wait, can you even use the mouse? I genuinely don't even know. Didn't know you could use the mouse. I just use the arrow keys and then Z, X, C, and V. But I only learned the game a couple hours ago and only spent like an hour and a half on it. So that's the best of my knowledge. I've been using GPT-4 for the last 4 to 5 days straight, creating a comprehensive business plan. My brain is nearly fried. Is this for your like your video editing side of things, with like the fact that you hired a new person and all that stuff? Or is this something else? Is this your ballet? Is this your ballet business that you're opening up? It's not opening up ballet business. As soon as I saw Call of Juarez keys pop up from the mystery bundle, I thought they'd be great for the Brawlhalla tournament. I want to win them fair and square. Yeah, awesome. No, that sounds perfect. I like that. Yeah. Get your practice in. Get those hours up. Because at the end of the day, even if I win, I'm not going to choose any of the games for myself. Unless, basically, I might take some of them if there's, like, if there's a bunch left and there's one that specifically I want. But this is about you guys getting free stuff, not me, so. It's gonna be wild. I think left mouse button is light attack and right mouse button is heavy attack. Oh, okay. So, yeah, just the same as the Z and X then. Yeah, I just find it easy to use a keyboard, so I didn't even think about using the mouse. Didn't even know it was a thing. It's a different thing which I'm kind of keeping secretive for now, but it's related to dance. Keep it secret. Keep it safe. Bum's the word. Yeah, Adam is gonna have to practice because I'm gonna clock in hours so I can be a complete menace to society. Good. We're gonna have some fierce competition. I wanna see like some top tier plays happening. I wanna see like genuine like thirst for those keys. I want to see the menace in society. I want to see it all. It's going to be amazing. 13 pages done so far, probably another 5 pages to go or so for the first draft. Jeez, man, this is why I'm not a businessman. Too much writing and reading. I don't do that. Instead, we play games like this. House Flipper. We're gonna crack on because it's almost 20. Well, we are 20 minutes in and we haven't started, so let's crack on. We're saving to go to the moon. We need to flip a couple houses, I think. I think that's probably the quickest way to do it. We flip a couple houses and then blah blah blah. Step one, step two, profit the moon. There we go. Should also probably focus on speedrun strats for Terraria. Yeah, do it. I know you said you weren't necessarily going for the keys, but there's a bunch of things in that document that allow you, that essentially Terraria, things in Terraria will get you keys, so get those speedruns down. Yeah, there will be I mentioned it in the document, but just in case people didn't notice it. We won't be coming in. We'll be coming in fresh. We'll be coming in completely fresh to the Terraria world. It'll be a new world, new characters. Everything will have to be done from the ground up, and we're just going to see how far we can get. I think we have 5 hours. It's either 5 or 6 hours. I think it might be 5 hours. And there's games to give away for things like, I think I said the best fish, the best build, the first person to get Crimtane or Demonite ore, depending what world we spawn. Yeah, there's like a whole bunch of things. What is the sensitivity like? Okay. So yeah. Get your practice on. Alright, this is my new house, by the way, everyone. Not sure if you guys are aware. Oh, did I do myself a solid and actually clean it up? I think I actually cleaned it up at the end of the last stream. So I should only have to paint and then do furniture. Alright, sick one. Oh, thank goodness. So we wanna flip this house and make bank. And then we can look at getting another house and flipping that one. Like the name suggests. Should I rush Wall of Flesh to mess with everyone? I mean, will anyone else actually... Because don't you have to be down there? Like, if you rush the Wall of Flesh and everyone else is just topside, won't they just see you die and then that'll be it? I mean, if you actually succeed in defeating the Wall of Flesh, I guess, then that'll kind of mess with people. But if you don't, it'll just be a bunch of you dying. Should be fun. Rushing the Wall of Flesh is pretty easy. You just kill as many queen bees as possible, get a ton of bee nades, and terrorize the wall. I see. I see we have a Terraria connoisseur in the building. That being said, Adam has also played his fair share of Terraria. I don't know how he is on his speedrun strats, but he's certainly played some Terraria before. Now, this is my own house, so I can actually do what I want here. Which is a terrifying thought. I'm not gonna spend any charm on it. What's the thing? Licorice All Sort. We're not gonna do the Licorice All Sort strat. Simply because we want to do this as quickly as possible. I'm gonna leave the green part in there because I don't think that matters. And we're just gonna paint some walls. Gonna relax and paint some walls. Tell you this though, the business is going to require about 100k US capital. Yikes. To get started for the first year. But our projected revenue, if done right, estimated between 500k and 2.4 mil in the first year. Bruh. You know something the rest of us don't. So that means you're going to be sending some funds my way then, yeah? When you're successful? For like inputting nothing at all? You're going to send me some love this way, yeah? At least give me a tier 1 sub, bruh. Please. I'm desperate. No, that sounds interesting. I hope things do go according to plan. That'd be great. That sounds wonderful. Because that also means that there's, I mean, I know you don't really rely on your streaming for, like, income or anything, but it means there's less pressure just in general for that sort of thing. So you can just sort of do stuff that you want more often, I guess. But the high capital requirement is why I'm focusing on this business plan to pitch to investors. Yeah, makes sense. If people are going to invest, they need to know that there's a reason to. I already know some Terraria speedrun strats. Could be quicker if they don't make Molotovs. Way more difficult to get that. Molotov strat, super easy, pre-1.3. Well, I don't know what version it's on currently. Isn't it on 1.4 now? But I want to see these speedrun strats. I mean, let's aim to fight the Moon Lords by the end of the stream, yeah? Never gonna happen. Well, here's the thing though. It kind of depends to a large extent. It will depend on how many people are there. I know that it does get more difficult with more people, but also the more people that we have makes it way easier to get more resources, which means we should, in theory, be able to advance faster. As long as everyone's roughly pulling their weight during boss fights, then we should have a little bit better of a chance of getting somewhere good. Especially if we have people that actually know what they're doing. So, yeah. Man, I'm looking forward to it. We shelved Terraria ages ago because I just wasn't quite vibing with it how I'd like to. And I think this is going to be a real good revival. Having like a bunch of people actually play along. Super excited for it. I'm not big on speedrunning. Yeah, no fair. Me either. You still know some good strats though. Just like in general, I'm sure. So that'll still help. Alright, gonna sell this. What other color do we want? Let's go. What goes good with orange? Raspberry. Yeah? That nasty green color, you're leaving it? Yeah. Well, only on the inside of the sills. The rest is that beautiful orange color. I'll certainly buy you a 4090. Yeah, I mean, if you make that 2.4 million that you're projecting, then that's the least you could do. For all I've done for you, he says, whilst doing nothing for him. You can get me a 4090, the most expensive card on the market. Seems legitimate to me. I wish this was how painting worked IRL. Wouldn't it be great? We could just go bloop and it's all done. Bruh. I'd paint my house right now if it was this easy. Don't even have to move the furniture. Just slap it down at the top of the wall. Bam. Bob's your uncle. There's bits of our house that need painting, and if it was this easy, I'd probably be doing it right now, actually. I'd probably be IRL streaming doing this right now. If it was this easy. Except that I don't really have a way to do an IRL stream, but that's beside the point. Like to do one eventually, though. It'd be fun. Alright, paint over the clock. Let's go full landlord style. Let's just paint over everything. Move nothing and paint over everything. And then charge tenants extra when it comes around to the next part. Like the next evaluation or whatever. And then we go, oh, all these things are broken. We're the ones that made them broken. But the tenant is there, so therefore it's their fault. And we're going to charge them. Which seems fair. Yeah? Seems fair, right? Terraria's on 1.4. Okay. I've been playing since like 1.2.4, I think. I don't even know when the first time I played Terraria was. I feel like it was a long time ago, but I don't really know when, and I don't know any of the versions. It wasn't as early as I played like Minecraft. I played Minecraft in like the alpha stage, I think. Let's do this room. Oh, actually, yeah, no, let's do this room. It's fine. Cream off-white? No, raspberry. This is kind of off-white, a little bit. We're making this raspberry. You haven't even... Aaron, I don't think you've even witnessed, like, the beauty that I usually paint. This is, like, this is actually relatively appealing compared to what we usually do. I don't know if you've ever heard of a licorice allsort, but that's usually what our walls look like. I just don't have time because this is a house I'm flipping, not a house that I'm doing up for someone or keeping myself.
Hello there.
Hey, Pete! Long time no see. How you doing? Watching paint dry stream? Yeah, let's do it. Do IRL paint dry stream. You can do it on your phone if it has a decent enough camera. Yeah, my phone's a Samsung Galaxy S8, which, to be fair, has a relatively decent camera, especially for what it is, but that thing is pretty old now, and it, like, struggles to keep up. I would really like to do an IRL stream of some description eventually, though. But that's, like, yeah, I just really didn't have the setup for it. Even if I wanted to at the moment. And I always have to stream at night. So, wouldn't really be able to do anything. It'd literally have to be like a special event or something. Which is when I do something like that anyway, but... Alright. Beautiful raspberry. I am alive! You are, Pete! Hello there, you are alive! Did the game have the Moon Lord when you finished... When you first started playing Terraria? That is a good question. I want to say no when I first started. The last time I played it and completed the game, it did definitely have Moon Lord. The first time, I don't think so. Oh, look at that floor. That floor is staying. What color can we put in to complement the lime green floor? Red. Bright red is the answer. I don't think the wall of flesh existed when I started playing. Wow. That was a while ago then. I've always known the wall of flesh. That's wild. I mean, it's a relatively old game, I guess, now. Oh, we have to actually, like, fix the walls for some reason. Dumb. How do I do that? Demolition, painting, cleaning? Package of tiles would be useful, says the game. Wait, it's plaster, isn't it? Don't I need plaster? Oh, yeah, here we go. Oh, I need to put plaster on the thing. Been surprised at how easy it is. I was at a horse show with Jess once and was chilling, drinking beers and streaming and chatting off the phone. Mic seemed to be decent quality too, but you can also get mic plug into your phone or a Bluetooth headset. Interesting. I mean, there is also, I'm not saying that the quality of yours would have been bad, but there is still a relative, like, quality bar that I would want to meet before I was to do an IRL stream. Like, it wouldn't be perfect by any stretch of the imagination, but I would want to try and reach a relatively good quality bar if I was going to do it. But yeah, at the moment, it's just a vague thought of nothing, so it's not like it's going to happen anytime soon. Just would be nice, would be cool one time, you know? We started playing because of Barjo and Hex on Good Game. Oh wow, that is back in the day. My cousin says that Hellstone armor was the highest armor when we started. Hellstone. Yeah, that's like... Isn't that one of the lowest tier hard mode armors at the moment? Like after... Oh well, maybe not at the moment. When I played, I'm pretty sure Hellstone was one of the first hardcore tiers, wasn't it? I don't know, it's been a while since I played. I really don't remember. And I was never particularly that much of an expert at it or that good at it. I just sort of stuffed around a bit, read some guides, and did the thing. It's fun, though. Should you plaster or asbestos? Asbestos. But unfortunately, I left that in my other pair of jeans, so we have to plaster. Well, asbestos the other rooms, though, no doubt. It probably wasn't super great, but I think people are more willing to forgive it a bit lower quality when it's IRL. You can stream 1080 on your phone? Really? I wouldn't trust that, but that sounds wild. Yeah, I mean, the thing is, for me, most of the time, what I strive for with the, just the stream in general, is, although I am, to some extent, like, trying to live up to a certain quality standard for the audience, actually most of it's kind of selfish. I actually want it to look good for me. I want to look at it and be like, yeah, that's like, I like that, I'd watch that, that looks good to me. And then by extension, sure, other people enjoy it, but a lot of the time I actually just do it because I want it to look good for me. That's right, you heard it first, folks. A streamer is selfish. What? Stop it. Alright, we're painting it all red. You mean molten armor? Was it molten? Also, that released with the original... That was released in the original build. It's highest in pre-hard mode, but sucks in hard mode. Ah, that's what I'm thinking. Yeah, that sounds right. Yeah, so it's like the top tier before you get to hard mode. Recommend Streamlabs app, though, instead of streaming via the Twitch app? For mobile streaming? Is it just like way better? I mean, the Twitch app is garbage, so it can't be hard. It really can't be hard. Most modern phone cameras are 1080 or even 4K. Yeah, well, see, that's the thing. Mine isn't modern, so. Yeah, like I said, it's an S8, so it's not really that modern. I don't know how well it'd do in general. It's already slowed down a bit recently. It's been struggling to keep up with stuff. Here we go, cyan. Boom. Big old bucket of paint. Smack it down. Well, there's the best alternative probably, which is GoPro Hero 11 Black for $400. Oh, I have that, yeah. Which can stream to Twitch and has excellent quality, almost equivalent to a 2 to 3 grand camera. Well, here's the thing, Aaron. I don't have $400. I haven't even spent that much on my phone itself. I would love to be able to do that. Because I have like a Hero 5 session, which is like so like bare bones and is kind of useless, but it suited the purposes that I needed for at the time. I would like to get like a much newer GoPro. One of the ones that has all the bells and whistles and be able to do stuff like that. But man, it's just expensive. It's one of the things that you can get me when you get your $2.4 million from your dance studio. Which is what I'm assuming you're doing with all that money. And then I can do IRL streams. Deal? Deal. I'm not going to look at his response. Everyone just drown out his response with yes. He said yes. Isaac, he said yes. Oh my gosh, Isaac, you've got a free GoPro. You're a genius. Yes, you did it. You're going to get a GoPro. I want to look at chat and I just want to see. Aaron has bought me a GoPro. Ideally use it in the wall flash run, throwable AoE damage. Throwable capable of AoE is huge, especially with managing the hungry. Well, is that also because if you have like throwable AoE stuff, there's so many bits, or like it's got so much, it's a long boy is what I'm trying to say, that it will just like damage it over time. And like damage multiple parts at once. I mean, these are all strats that will come in handy when we do it next Saturday. Correction, it's equivalent to a $2,000 camera if you have sufficient lighting. Yeah, that's always the kicker, right? You can have like a real fancy camera, but if your lighting's terrible, it's gonna look terrible. People like the. It's amazing how many people go out and buy this super expensive camera and then just have no lighting and then wonder why everything looks terrible. And then they're just like, oh, the problem is that the camera's not expensive enough. No, you just didn't light the scene properly. The camera doesn't have the right. Like, it's not getting enough light into the sensor to actually capture things properly. And even aside from that, just aesthetically, you know, one bright white downlight on top of your face and no other surrounding lights looks terrible. Aside from any sensor reasons, it looks terrible. Your version might be able to stream Twitch. Oh, no, I highly doubt it. Mine can do, like, nothing. It's terrible. It's supposed to be able to, like, Bluetooth to my phone, or Wi-Fi to my phone, or both. And the app straight up doesn't work. Like, it's actually just doesn't work. It did originally, but it's broken now. I don't know why, but I've tried it on numerous occasions to get it to work, and it just doesn't work. It's not like... I mean, it could be my specific unit, but... I think it's just... That one is just not that good. It's very... bare bones. Dance competition. Oh, competition. I thought it was going to be a studio. It's going to be a competition, is it? Ooh. Ooh. Are you gonna be judging the dance competition or participating though? Oh, we painted that whole section? Oh, because this is like the side of the staircase. Right. I think we've almost painted everything. That's outside, yeah. We're gonna have to do cladding on the outside as well. This house is gonna take like the whole stream. Basically, damaging as many of the elements as possible. Yeah, gotcha. It's like why you have, why you use, weapons that have, like, piercing damage against, like, the Great Destroyer, the Great Devourer, Devourer of Worlds, the big worm dude, because you hit all of your segments at once. Let's paint in here as well. I have had a lens once, which is such a wide aperture, not 0.95 f-stop, which would display a brighter image than you physically see with your eyes, and the amount of grain was unbearable. 0.95 f-stop compared to a raw video format equals excellent low light capabilities. Yeah, people, and people just think that, oh, it's got great numbers. It's an excellent camera. It's got a great lens. It's got, you know, all this stuff, whatever. Oh, I missed up there. That's all I need. That will be enough. No. False. Learn some basic 3-point lighting and instantly your scene will go from looking absolutely god-awful to looking not necessarily incredible, but a lot better. Like, a lot better. And then you get like more fancy with some 5-point lighting and stuff, but man, just 3-point lighting will set you up pretty well. No, it was very bearable, not unbearable. I could shoot in the dark and it still looked good. Oh, the amount of grain was very bearable. Oh, that's just a weird phrase to say. I think that's why I instantly corrected to unbearable. I've not heard of anyone ever use the term very bearable. But yeah, that does sound like it's would be very good for night shooting. I'm almost painting the garage. Weapons that can damage multiple elements of the Eater of Worlds is also good. Yeah. I think that's like the main recommended thing, is just to get stuff that has pierce damage when fighting him. I think that's like a... I don't know, there's like a pre-hard mode weapon. Is it pre-hard mode or just after hard mode? I don't know. There's a weapon that's fairly common using against him. That does like a whole bunch of pierce damage. Beautiful! Look at that garage! Look at it! And then, once you've finished washing out your eyes with bleach, look at this kitchen. Look at the kitchen. Wonderful. Where else do we need to paint? We've got a learned toad. Let's do that real quick. While we think about what we do next, let's learn some facts. Everybody ready for some facts? You look very disabled. Oh yeah, what a quote. Alright, are we ready? It's time to learn. It's time to learn some facts.
In Latoma, Kansas, it's illegal to throw knives at men wearing striped suits.
Everyone else, however, encouraged.
Johnny Depp suffers from self-injury.
Wow, that was random.
The lifeboat was patented in 1845.
Was that before or after the Titanic sank? I know it was before some morons went down in a submarine. Okay, let's get back on track. Let's get back on track, shall we? Let's continue. Didn't know Toad was Australian? Have you seen how many toads there are? Do you know how many toads there are? In the Mario universe? There's bound to be an Australian toad. Titanic was in 1912, I think. But genuinely could not tell you. So I'm just gonna say yes, that sounds right. You're 100% correct. Because I have no point of reference. I don't care enough about it at all. I've literally been to like a restaurant that's themed around it as well. Because my wife and their family went there and I went there as well. What am I looking for here? Floor. And I just couldn't tell you. Alright, let's put pink linoleum flooring.
I'm overjoyed to hear that Garrus has replaced Ulrich as the captain of the guard. I'm sure he'll do a fine job.
That is so good to hear. Pink linoleum flooring everywhere. And I mean everywhere. Look at the bloody... Look at the lovely lino in this place, Marge. Struth. Even in here. Lino. I remember back in the day when lino was actually a thing. One of the first houses I lived in had lino all through the kitchen. And back in the day, it wasn't like a weird thing. And I guess people still do it now, but it feels like such a 90s or 80s thing. Most of the time, most people would rather have the floorboards, the actual proper wooden floorboards, because it looks so much better. But look at this, though. Beautiful. Beautiful. Also, I tried to play Fallout 4 in a typical Fallout fashion. The instant the game was started, it crashed to the desktop. No mods or anything. It just works. It just works. Yeah, when we raided... Oh, hello. When we raided Ez the other night, we were talking about Fallout and her experience with Fallout and the fact that I was playing Fallout 3. And the first time that I ever watched her stream was during, I think it was, oh, God damn it. I think it was Fallout 4. And she was like, oh yeah, I tried playing New Vegas, but it just crashed. Like, I just couldn't get it to work at all. I was like, I'm already struggling with, like, I've already had issues with Fallout 3, let alone when we go to New Vegas or Fallout 4. So I'm not looking forward to what sort of issues we're going to have with either of those. I'm hoping it's going to be smooth sailing, but I'm knowing it's not. It's not going to be. No way. Certified Bethesda moment. You know it's a Bethesda game when it doesn't work properly. Alright, I think that's all the flooring done. What else do we need? I'm just trying to think what the next big job is. I like getting the big stuff out of the way first, then we can go through. Do we have lighting everywhere? I think we should. Yeah, I think we should. Let's have a look at what people want, what the buyers want. Never had an issue with Fallout 4 personally, but it's been a while since playing it, and I've played it on both Xbox One and PC. Yeah, I don't even remember the first few times I played it. I think when I played it completely vanilla, I didn't really have many issues. But certainly playing on PC through 3, I've had a few issues. And I've certainly heard a lot of other people had a lot of issues with all of, pretty much any Bethesda game when doing, especially when doing any sorts of modding. Big family needs 2 or more bathrooms. You know what? I don't care about the Johnson family. They can go piss in a sink for all I care, as long as it's not a sink in my house. Okay, let's go for the... Let's aim for the Smoth family, shall we? They want a place where they can spend time with the whole family. Alright, the garage? Question mark? Where can... We need, like, a lounge room, like a living room or whatever. Wow, there really isn't, like, a living room at all, is there? Yeah, I'm gonna, like, convert... We don't have any bathroom running yet. Let's convert one of these into a lounge room. I mean, this is like a study. Oh, this is a living room. This'll do. I've stolen the child. Really can't wait for Starfield, but I'm 100% certain it's gonna be a buggy mess like always. Yeah, I'm still not set on Starfield. I want it to be great. And honestly, I genuinely hope it is great, but I'm... rain hanging TV. Oh my goodness. They don't need a TV that big. That'll do though. Ooh. Let's get rid of this though. We don't need this. There's a lot of things about it that actually look genuinely really good. There's just a few things, like the whole 1,000 planets thing that still just goes, ugh. Could you not have made anything else your selling point? Let's put that right in front of the heater. BRB smoke break. My sleep schedule is all stuffed up, so I'll be up all night. Well, I already have been. It's 5 a.m. here. Well, first of all, quit smoking. You said you were gonna quit. Damn it. Second of all, get some sleep if you need it. We need stuff for the lounge. Oh, wait. Living room? No. Is it in a section? Furniture? Living room. There we go. That'll do. Weed, not cigarettes? Oh, it's different, is it? I don't smoke anything at all, so I wouldn't know. I haven't had a cigarette in 2 months, probably. Is it different? I mean, obviously, it's different, but, like... Is there no nicotine? Like, is there nothing that creates cravings in weed? Surely the, is it cannabis? I know nothing about drugs at all. Is that not addictive? I want a table. Give me a coffee table. This. Sure. Boom. That's the world's saddest coffee table. Look at that terrible thing. That is awful. Weed has health benefits, believe it or not. THC, the active substance, is anti-inflammatory. Yeah, I think you told me about that. I think my mum has told me about that. Actually. If you can even believe that. Artistic disorder? What are you talking about? talking about a woman. Can we put like toys in here or something? Toys. No. Kids? It is addictive, not going to act like I'm not addicted to it, but it's a much safer alternative to cigarettes. Yeah, I guess. I mean, yeah, it's definitely... I imagine it would be better. You know what? Oop, that's enough of that for now. Let's look at...
That means the killer has been inside with us all along. You and I aren't murderers. So that leaves one person. We must prepare to defend ourselves.
Wait, are we saying that Aaron's now a murderer? That escalated quickly. Alright, here's a nice rug for the kids. Boom. Rug. We did it. Okay, I was actually supposed to be looking at this. So we're aiming at... We don't care about the Johnson family. They're twats. We're looking here. So we've done that one, I think. We need two or more bathrooms. And there won't be more children without a comfortable bed, if you know what I mean. Alright, so we need a comfortable bed. And we need bathrooms. So I think this is supposed to be a bathroom. So that hasn't been done at all. Actually, no. Let's just look. Instead of looking for toiloy, let's look for a bathroom. Does this have... Oh no, that's not fittings. I need the actual fittings. Fixtures, there we go. Can I put... that in there? Is that gonna... You can buy a toilet mounted here. I still don't understand why there's like... Oh no, that's mounted. Okay, that looks like that's mounted. There are some of them that don't seem to actually mount properly. Okay, so this is a toilet. We're gonna make it into like a bit of a washroom situation. We're gonna need to paint the walls, or not paint them, because that would be madness. We can get glass walls now? That was always there, probably was. We wanna get... wall. I cannot do it now. Oh, sad. What am I looking for here? Damn it, my... What am I looking for here? It's not under furniture. Decorations? Occasional? No. Oh, you know what? It's just in this section, not that section. That's what the problem is. That's what the problem is. No one's ever really overdosed on weed, but people die from alcohol every day. And when they legalize it, there is another source of tax revenue for the state. People quote that a lot, and that's not technically true. I mean, it's fairly accurate, but people have certainly died from being high off their bejesus from weed before. They didn't die from the weed, but they did die because they were bereft of their senses due to the weed. But far less, certainly far less than the like actual smoking. The smoking would just outright kill you. Tiling and paneling, is that what I want? There we go, that's better. Nobody dies from weed, but I guess what you're saying. Yeah, but that's like saying that nobody dies from jumping off a cliff. They die from the fall. Obviously, but the result is the same. I'm not saying that it's not better, because it 100% is far better, and you're a lot less likely to die from that. But saying that nobody has ever died from it is just frankly not true. And people quote that all the time, saying that they're like, oh, you know, it's the best thing ever because no one's ever died from it, which just, again, simply isn't true. Look at this place. Look at this place. This place is lovely. I bought more panels than I needed to. Is there somewhere else we can put this paneling? No, it's fine. But if somebody's going to get high and do something stupid, they could just as easily do something else. What, as in do a different type of drug? Is that what you mean? Well, yeah. But that still doesn't discount the fact that people have done that whilst on weed. Again, I'm not saying that weed is, like, specifically a bad thing and that if you have weed, you will die. But I'm just saying it's ridiculously naive to say that nobody has ever died from weed, because it's not really how that works. We want bathroom stuff. Let's get some sinks. This one looks like a banger. Look at it. Just one door green. Just one door green. Yeah, that's what I mean. Weed is the safest drug out there, even safer than caffeine, because caffeine is a drug and caffeine causes heart conditions. Yeah, no, I'm not disagreeing with you. I 100%. I would 100% agree that it's definitely one of, if not the safest classified drug out of the ones that you can get, especially non-prescription. But people justifying it as something... Oh, is that a shower? Oh, that's a shower. Right. People justifying it saying that it's never killed anyone just simply isn't 100% true. Like, I get what they're saying, and on a technicality, there's some point to what they're saying, but it's still not true. There we go, we can fit the shower! Yes! We did it! I do think it's ridiculous when people say weed isn't a drug. Yeah, weed's a drug just as much as caffeine is a drug, like you said. It's 100%, they're both drugs. The way that you classify drugs is all wildly different. And, you know, there's different... Saying that something is a drug is not inherently bad or good. It's just saying that it has... Usually, one of the main properties of that is an addictive nature or an addictive substance. A substance within the drug that makes it addictive, which caffeine. Extremely addictive. Weed, addictive. Rocket fuel. Not the rocket fuel, obviously. Tobacco and stuff like that. Extremely addictive. Do I need anything else for a bathroom? I've got sink, I've got toilet, I've got shower. I don't have bath, but I don't think I need one. Probably could do with some lights. Could be a good idea. People don't realize there are a lot of drugs that are socially acceptable. I'm a Christian, but I scoff at Christians who say weed is a sin simply by it being a drug. I'm like, you go to church and chug 5 cups of coffee by lunchtime. Ça descend près de tout le gain time. L'addictive par isentive ne necessary. Just needs to be something to cause a physiological effect. Really? Yeah, I'm not 100%. I don't want to give any, what's that? I don't want to give any, absolutes on the definition of what drug is, because I don't technically know. But I do definitely know that people definitely misunderstand the definition of it quite willfully. There we go. Beautiful. We addictive and I don't miss the tea. Hey. Yeah, no, I also agree with you on that, Aaron. They just go, oh, it is drug. Drug is bad. Bad is sin. Sin is Satan. Satan is not Christian. Therefore, you Satan. The gymnastics, they go through a bunch of states. And look, I will never do weed from a personal belief that I just, you know, it's not for me. It's as simple as that. And there may be some amount of basis in religion from how I was brought up and how I grew up and stuff like that. It's not because of that specifically. I just don't think it's for me. If other people want to do it, as long as they're not hurting other people, go for your life. Not my problem. It's only when it becomes my problem that it's a problem. Let's get some kitchen furniture. We need some stuff in the kitchen. Hey, Conqueror, how you doing? Welcome. Believe a drug is anything that affects your brain chemistry in any way. That sounds about right, yeah. Medicine or any other substance with psychological effect when ingested or otherwise introduced into the body. Yeah, so exactly. Very broad. And that doesn't mean good or bad. That, like, even just with that definition alone, you can very much tell that it's not just like good or bad. It's just, this is a fact. Alright, we need a dining table. Let's do this tiny little thing. Pop. Don't mind me lurking in the background at DRF's. Fun fact, weed is semi-legal in Vic already and can be gotten on script. Yeah, so I am aware that it's like, it's legal, medicinal weed is legal here. I am aware of that because I think, isn't it that the THC isn't present in the medicinal version? Is that what it is? Don't quote me on that because I'm not quite sure, but it's something like that, that you are allowed to have it as long as it's prescribed for conditions, because it has a lot of health benefits, as Aaron's pointed out. And as I'm sure other people are aware. Oh, this is like a second lounge room here. Let's put another TV in. That's good TV. Adam's addicted to drugs? Yeah. You drink coffee, right? Let's put a crappy TV in here. Let's put this just crappy little one here. The other one's got like the friggin' mega TV, and this has just got this old, like, 60s TV. Just gonna move some of this junk around a bit. Boom. Beautiful. Wait, hold on. Let me have a look. For me, it honestly changed my life with the medical problems I was having. Only thing I found that gives me any real relief. Oh, I see. Yeah, I think stuff like Parkinson's, it helps as well. Like, there's a bunch of things that it helps. Oh, it's some of the strongest weeds you can get. THC is present in the medicinal version, but there are medicinal types that don't contain considerable amounts of THC. Okay, I must have been thinking of something else. It also depends on what medical problems you have, on what is the best, and what is best to use. Yeah, that makes sense. Technically, penicillin is a drug by definition as well. It has been, well, to put it lightly, very beneficial. Exactly. It's not as simple as drug good, drug bad. It never is. Those are generally called CBD weed, but technically THC is a CBD cannabinoid. It's one of many CBDs. Right. Everyone's learning. Welcome, everyone. Welcome to the drug stream, where we learn about drugs and all the benefits of having drugs stay in school, kids, but also take drugs. Disclaimer. Adam, can we have the disclaimer? Can we have the disclaimer in the chat, please? I feel like we need the disclaimer. Oh, we left the plaster
Stop
in
Stop it. Get some help.
Yeah, please do. Please get some help. Wait, you're talking to me? That's rude. This thing looks... They look rough as. Let's get rid of those. Let's get rid of all the child's toys as well. They don't need toys. Actually, you know what? Let's get rid of the child. We don't need a child. We just need another bedroom. Easy. Easy clap. It can help with dementia too. Yeah, you're right. Yeah, I've heard that. Like I said, my mum has like done a decent amount of research into it. And has used... I don't know exactly what. I don't want to speculate on stuff. I don't know. I think she's used like CBD oil or something. Like legal CBD oil stuff. And it's helped with a lot of things. Let's get bed. Let's get bed. Where is bed? Okay, Google. Where is bed? Furniture? Bedroom. Also, lots of people who have suffered from traumatic brain injuries can also promote new brain cell growth. Really? Maybe I need to take weed because all of my brain cells are dead from listening to you guys. I'm kidding. Relax. Relax. I'm joking. It's a joke. Complete joke. I actually meant I've lost all the brain cells due to listening back to my own thoughts. Okay, let's get this one. There we go. Slap! Look at that. Let's make the bed. Boom. Somebody just disliked that we did that. Well, they can have a soup. We should put a chest of drawers in here. Some drugs severely hinder the mental state and can be problematic to not only the person who takes them, but the people they know. And others literally just kill bad bacteria and help people not die from preventable diseases. Exactly. It's honestly kind of hilarious when people just try and go drug bad. And then they just go, oh... So you've never taken Panadol then, obviously. You've never had a headache. You've never been asthmatic. You've never needed antibiotics or anything like that. You must just be like the pinnacle of health. Either that or a cesspit of bacteria if you've never taken any drugs ever. Yeah, let's get a wardrobe. There we go, this one will do. First one I saw. Bam. Oh, wait. That way? That way. Let's put it right in front of the window. Make sure that light really gets in there. And erodes the back of that bookshelf. Wardrobe, rather. Beautiful. Alright, well this place is looking alright. Let's turn the lights on. Instead of going and smoking, I'm here riling up the crowd, just doing my job. Look, if you don't do it, I'm gonna have to do it. And that's just a lot of work. If somebody else can do it for me, and then I can just, you know, just make it even worse, that's really the ideal scenario. Let's get some walls in here, shall we? Ugly sweater wallpaper? Yeah, let's have wallpaper. Let's have wallpaper in a wet area. That sounds like a great idea. There we go, little dude. Oh, I've still got this stuff. How do I get rid of it? Can I? Oh, I can just put it down? Alright, and then sell it. There we go. I mean, I could have just had like one separate panel. I probably should have done that, but I didn't. Oh, look at that. Beautiful. Beautiful. It's like, oh, look, Aaron is here. Let's get to controversial topics. Yeah, come on, Aaron. Usually the political and controversial topics are supposed to be only on our co-streams. Why are you bringing it here on my day off? My day off the political stream. We're just trying to have a nice time, and then you have to bring your drugs into it. God damn it. Can't take you anywhere. This is the real reason you're gonna owe me that $2.4 million. For psychological damages incurred over the period of our streaming together. Too short? God damn it. Beautiful. Alright, we need a toilet. For me, the biggest things have had pain relief, nausea, control, increased appetite, controlling panic attacks and PTSD flashbacks. And that's a lot of things that the doctors had me trying. So many things for it, and it just wasn't doing anything. Then I tried weed, and it kind of just helped with all of them. And I was like, maybe this isn't so bad. I mean, that's the other flip of the coin, right? You can tell someone something is bad until you're blue in the face. But if they have tried that thing, and anecdotally for them, it has seemingly cured a whole bunch of things... It doesn't matter who's right or wrong at that point. For them, it has worked. And for them, it is good. Because they're not in pain anymore. So you try and tell someone that's in that situation that it's bad, you're talking to a brick wall. Because clearly for them, it's not. We need a toilet. That's what we need. This one. The kissing compact. Does this one work though? I feel like this one we've tried before and it didn't really work. Yeah, it just lets me put it anywhere. Yeah, I don't think it's a real toilet. I think it's actually a seat or something. Kind of annoying. Yeah, I think I've tried to use that one a few times and it keeps doing that. Let's go the golden one, the golden throne. There we go, look at that. Beautiful. Boom. Assemble. So ballet? Oh, that's right. That's the evolution of the conversation, right? We go from massively political and controversial ballet. It's the logical progression of any good conversation, let's be real. Oh, we need a sink and bathtub. Sink. Exactly, good for some, not for all. Also, if you abuse it, it will abuse you. It's a balance. Yeah, that's the other thing. Everything can be bad. I mean, it's the classic saying, right? It's so it's so blindingly obvious, but also incredibly relevant in a lot of situations. Anything in excess is just that, excess. Everything in moderation. That's the whole point. If you have things out of moderation, you have too much of anything, it is exactly the point at which it is too much. Oh, that's another one of the ones that's not a real sink. God damn it. Built-in sink my ass. Alright, let's use this one then. I mean, there are some things... Well, here's the thing, actually. Most things are fine in a small amount. But eventually, you'll have too much. Uranium? You can have a very small amount of, and you will be okay. There's plenty of radioactive objects that we use daily, but if you have too much uranium, and it's a lot smaller threshold, you will die. Most things you can have an amount of, and it's not a bad thing. It's just the threshold changes. Bathtub. Here we go. F pain, especially the type that can't do anything else to get rid of or lessen. Yeah. That can just get in the bin. pain that you like can't even get. Let's go yellow. Oh my goodness, that bathtub is the half the size of the goddamn room. Guess we're not getting that one. This one maybe? Yeah, that's the worst kind of pain. You can't do anything about it. Why does this one not fit? This one looks like it fits. Oh, well, I guess not. Is there a much smaller bathtub we can get? For me, I think I may have some form of undiagnosed ADHD, and it helps me focus when I get overwhelmed/stressed. Yeah, see, I definitely have some form of undiagnosed ADHD as well. And honestly, I almost probably should try that. Because it probably would help. Because I have heard that as well, that it can help with that. But like I said, it's just something that's not going to be for me, just in general. Okay. But everyone else can try it. And when it ends up being a good thing for them, awesome. Also, I'm a grown adult now. And it's never been so bad that I've not been able to manage it. So, classic millennial just learned to live with the thing. Only understood that it was even a thing once I reached, mid-20s. Late 20s. Let's just fix that up real quick. There we go. It's off the wall and at the other angle. Perfect. That's exactly what I wanted. All right, let's see what the buyers want. We're looking at the Smoth family again. Oh, for a second I thought they weren't even there anymore. That's something you find it helps with too? The ADHD?
Really?
Wait, you want to build a sink in your ass? Do you have any uranium? Yeah, I have a uranium sink up my ass. Did you not keep up with the conversation? Jeez! Dihydrogen monoxide too? Can be bad when too much? You have too much water, you drown yourself. You have too much of anything. It is too much. There won't be more children in a couple words. Yeah, we fixed that. Two bathrooms, at least two. We've got two now. There's no place we can spend. Okay, I think we've solved all of the problems that they had. I need to double check that we're not missing anything. I think we've basically fixed it. We've got two bedrooms, two bathrooms, two lounge rooms, a garage. Let's sell this. And a kitchen. I think I can sell this place. I think we're good. Yeah, let's do it. Let's sell it. Random fact, back on the topic of things that are poison and how most things that are in the right amount can kill you. Did you know that with nicotine in liquid form, it actually takes less of it to kill you than cyanide? Wow. Did not know that. No. Know that nicotine is extremely dangerous. You have to use gloves while handling it. Wow. Yet people smoke it. Obviously because they don't know that. Or they do know it, but they've done it for so long that they're so addicted they can't stop. I made the mistake of getting some of my hand once. Was not fun time. Yikes. Like from a vape? Jeez. It was like a concentrate that you use mixed in with
non-nice juice.
Yikes.
Just because liquid nicotine is highly concentrated. Yeah, exactly. It's like the, it's the same. This is a great analogy, right? This is a perfect analogy. It's exactly the reason why Americans hate Vegemite. Let's take a moment for everyone to adjust to what I just said then. Liquid nicotine is like Americans not being able to enjoy Vegemite. Then let's circle back around to what the hell that means. Vegemite is a concentrate. Americans think it's like Nutella, and they spread it all over the place, and then go, this is gross. But in actuality, you take the tiniest, tiniest, tiniest bit, and you dilute it over the entire piece of toast, and then it's basically like a light salting on the toast. I personally don't like Vegemite, but that's how you're supposed to have it. And in a cigarette, I imagine there's a tiny bit of the nicotine spread across, rather than the amount that you would have in liquid nicotine, all like concentrated into one part. All right, we're aiming at the Smoth family, so we want to see them on top. Johnson family can piss off. There they are. They're on top. 267. Only 30 grand profit. I was kind of hoping for more. I can counter offer and I will in a second, but I'm just going to catch up on chat real quick. The vape juice itself isn't as concentrated and dangerous. They're talking like if you bought a bottle of just straight nicotine liquid. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, otherwise you would just die from vaping once. Vaping. You wouldn't even once. Not even once. A scraping? Yeah. Or Vegemite? It's a scraping. They don't sell Vegemite here? Yeah, but you see these things all the time. Like YouTubers or like Jimmy Fallon or something like that. That have got their hands on a jar of Vegemite somehow. You know, they couldn't necessarily get it in the States, but somehow they've got it. And then they just slap it on like a bunch of Nutella and then just go, This is actual cancer. And I don't disagree with them necessarily, but they're having it completely wrong because it's like cordial. It's a concentrate. You don't put a whole bottle of cordial into a glass, like into an empty glass, and then drink that glass whole. You put water in to dilute it because it's a concentrate. Think they sell Marmite in the UK? Yeah. Similar, but not the same. It's a very similar product, but Vegemite, I think, is the Aussie brand. Yes, yeah, that's correct. That is correct. Let's try and negotiate with terrorists. I mean, with the Smoth family. Well, what's the difference? Will they take double? Double that? We don't have that much money, sorry. Okay. Well, in that case, refuse the offer. Really? Oh, what a waste of time. I did all of that. Can I not do another counter offer? Can I not be like, okay, well, how about just an extra 20 grand? God damn it. I went too high. Now I have to accept that. So sad. Vegemite brand returned to Australian ownership in 2017 when Bega Cheese purchased it alongside other assets from Mondelez International. Were they not Australian for a while? I mean, it's definitely like an Australian product, but I guess not all Australian products are necessarily made in Australia. Maybe that's what it was. Or owned by an Australian company. How much did I just earn then? It was, well, I know it was 30 grand, but like, how close are we now? I don't think we're much closer at all. We've got this one. We could sell this once we buy another place, though. That's the problem. Because what we want is we want this, the moon base. We're not even halfway there. This kind of takes so much longer than I thought. Do I buy another house? We could buy the family house. Yeah, let's do that. Oh no, if I buy that, I won't have any money to decorate it. Oh, but then the next best is 23? Come on now. Come on now. Why? I just want a moon base. Please. I just want to buy a moon base. Is there a way to sell the house that I'm in? Oh, there's a head flashlight. Was that always there? If I could sell this house, then I would buy... No, I don't think I can. We might have to do a small job first. Let's do this one. We're gonna try and do this one and then see if we can afford the more expensive house. The family house, and then try and flip that one. We really need to be making more than like 30 grand though, otherwise it's gonna take so flippin' long. Let's just sell everything. Right, sell that. Sell all the trash! Apparently people are buying the trash. Okay, it's got cockroaches. Come back and deal with that later. When we do our second pass. Lovely. Look at all that grease. Okay, that's outside. We don't want that. This is... Oh, that's in there. Right. Have I... Oh, is that it? That's the whole house. Okay, it's a lot smaller than I thought it was going to be. Right, let's get the mop out. Sometimes they come good, sometimes they do it every time. Okay, you guys talk about vapes. I did not get it on the start of that conversation. Let's do this. Got it. So next week, what's next week? Does anyone know what next week is? Like, date-wise? I think technically next week was actually supposed to be House Flipper. So I don't know if we want to do another House Flipper. I mean, it'll depend on whether we actually get any keys between now and then. I'm not sure if we will. I don't have any on the go. I don't know if we want to just do this again, because technically this is the first week slot for the Wednesday rotation. Or if we want to play something like Last Starship or Thriving City or Moons of Ardan or something. Eat Blood. There we go. Because I'm down for any of those, honestly. Come on, suck the cockroaches up, quickly! Hello? Why can we not get these ones? What is with these ones?
Not a sex thing.
No, it's not. It's you're right, it's not. Is my aircon not on? I didn't even realize. What I was just silently roasting. Oh, the cockroaches have gone. Cool. Let's mop in here. Just, you know, a small cleaning, as the lady said. These places are always like they've had a flipping bomb detonated in them. Oh, there's a box under it. Oh, right. Have we been... If I clean the window in the other room. Is that all of it? No. But for anyone that missed earlier conversation, just to completely turn things around away from the drug conversation. Not because I don't want to talk about the drugs. But just because I do want to talk about... Am I missing anything in here? The anniversary stream. Mentioned it earlier on. It's been mentioned in the Discord. But in case anyone didn't catch the conversation. The anniversary stream. The 2-year anniversary stream. The 12-hour 2-year anniversary stream. Is next Saturday. We're going to be doing a whole bunch of things, and we're giving away over 50 games for completely free. You can win them via the Brawlhalla tournament, by playing Terraria with us, by interacting with the chat in The Sims, you know, showing us a funny hat. It doesn't have to be in The Sims. It can be IRL, showing us a cool hat. There's a whole bunch of different ways you can win stuff, and there's a whole bunch of prizes to give away, and, and I'm super looking forward to the stream. You guys can play along with us when we play Terraria, and you can play against us when we play, Brawlhalla, and like I said, yeah, there's plenty of fun, prizes to be won. It's going to be a wild time. I'm super looking forward to it. Not because I don't want to talk about drugs. Can we make that a quote? Yes, we literally can. Adam can make that a quote. And I'm sure he will. He's probably already on his way to doing it. What is the command? I think it's a mod-only command. I don't think it works for normal. Oh, wait. Oh, I was going to say, yeah, you are a mod, aren't you? It's like, it's weird. Yeah, it's quote. There you go. Adam's put in there. It's not, for some reason, it's not the same as like everyone else's quote add command. It's like the syntax is weird for some reason. I don't know why, but it is. Okay, I'm getting super distracted. I need to just focus on a room and get it done. My ADHD is like, bruh! Let's just do a thing, okay? Let's do this. Let's paint this room. What color do they want it? Actually, we can do this, right? Here we go. And I can't believe I didn't know about this originally. You could just click on it. Although I think... No, I'm pretty sure that I remember finding out, or at least... Seeming like they added it after I complained about it. I'd like to say that that was my doing. You're all welcome. So I remember complaining about it. Oh, hello? What's going on here? I remember complaining about it in a couple streams, and then like a couple streams after that, it was a feature. I was like, yes, this is amazing.
Silly Billy! God damn you!
I don't know what I'm trying to say.
You nincompoop!
It's true. I am the silliest of billies and a nincompoop. You got me. Velvety Peach. is the color we're going for here. Goodness. So, do these... Oh, they do count now. Usually, they haven't counted. So in that last house that I sold that had all these crappy parts around the frames, probably could have gotten a lot more money. Well, maybe not a lot more money, but a bit more money if I had have actually painted those. Oh well. I did the landlord job. Alright, electrical outlet. Alright, there we go. I'm an electrician. Look at me go. But yes, just randomly get distracted for like 20 minutes. 12-hour live stream. Oh. Oh, we have to assemble the light bulbs. When did that happen? Prizes to be won. It's starting at 10 a.m. Australian Eastern Standard Time on the 8th of July. Let's go to a small one. And it will be going until 10 p.m. So wherever you are around the world, whether you're in America, whether you're in the UK, whether you're in Australia, you will have a chance, you will have an opportunity, you will have the privilege of coming along and winning those prizes. So do it. Which day you should set a timer to remind viewers? I have a time. Well, I literally have a thing in my Discord that's like a countdown timer. That has a continuous tick down timer for when it is. I mean a command timer in chat? Well, I mean, I talk about it. I've been talking about it for the lead up to the stream. I don't know that they'd, like, if people are curious, they'll usually just ask. It would be like, it'd be just as effective for me to just talk about it, because I also want to talk about the fact that there's, like, giveaways and stuff, rather than... Like, it would be just as effective as them just putting in the command, so I'll just talk about it. But yeah, there is a countdown timer. There we go. Adam's put it in the chat. That's the this exact time. Unless I sleep for 12 hours straight. I mean, I wouldn't put it past you doing that just to spite me. Just to miss the stream deliberately, so you've got an excuse. Not even like, oh, you forgot? Like, no, I remembered, and I deliberately slept through all of it. So rude. Okay. Paint that. Beautiful. Look at that lovely white. To clarify, a timer is when you have a command that automatically populates into chat every so many chat lines and every so many minutes. But I don't know what you use. Nightbot, for example, allows that feature. I imagine most bots do. Yeah, well, the thing is, I've probably got about 15 different command lines on a timer, and it already can get a little bit, not necessarily crowded, but like, it takes a while for all of them to cycle through, is I guess what I'm saying. And for something that I can just say, like, and will, I am like bringing up every now and then in the lead up to, it just feels a little bit redundant. It's not a terrible idea, it's just, I think it would be... It would be a lateral move, basically, is what I reckon. In my specific instance. 15. Yeah, well, we've got... And now I'm actually curious. Hold on. I'm gonna fix up whatever this thing is that's broken. Do I have to, like, change the light bulbs? Electrical outlet. Oh my goodness, it's behind this chair. There we go. Now I'm down there. There's one! The subscriber soundboard. No, I'll tell you exactly how many there is in a second. Some of them are like specialist ones that don't run all the time. Like the one for our multi-stream. And the one for Lynx. When I'm playing a game that people can join in with. And I've got like a charity one and stuff. Or like an event one. But there is a few of them. Alright, I'm curious now. I've got to find out. Hold on. You don't wire that up correctly to the house burn down? I wish. I would deliberately not wire it up correctly to see that happen. Alright, here we go. Timers. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 normally. And then 11, the multi one. Which is obviously only on the multi streams. 12, 13, 14. On events, anniversary, giveaway, and link, which is the ones that are obviously going to be coming up. And then 15. Literally exactly 15. Exactly 15. A donate one for when we do the actual charity one. Where you can, the link where you can actually donate to things. So yeah. I have Discord, commands, merch, schedule, socials, Spotify, YouTube, sounds, Prime, and gift. Gifts. Well, and then there's multi-anniversary, giveaway, link, and donate. So, yeah, that's the main reason why I wouldn't do it. Because there's just so many of them there already that already sort of fill all the purposes we need. And like I said, I can just, if people... I will tell people automatically, and also if people haven't heard somehow, they can ask, and I will tell. Oh, this is going to be a medium one. I think I've been overspending. Permanent markers aren't actually permanent. Gotta love that bad advice. Marvin's like, he can be very helpful sometimes. You know what I've actually been interested in? What I would really love to be able to try and set up is like a proper actual... Like, we make the joke all the time about the fact that Marvin isn't actually sentient, and he is just a glorified toaster. Because he is. He's programmed with like 100 and something responses or whatever. Not including the ones that are on API, that is literally just like, I don't even know how many are in that API. Still too much. But I would love to do like a, I would love to be able to figure out, I don't know if it's possible yet, but I would love to be able to figure out a proper like AI generated one where you can like, even if it was not necessarily Marvin but somebody else, like another bot that you could talk to, and it would like give a proper generated response rather than just response from a text line. From like a designated amount of commands, because I think people would get some interesting use out of that. Nagging is always charming. It's true. Somebody gave my wife that advice. Marvin's been in your house already. You didn't even know it, but he's there giving your wife advice. Now you're scared. Marvin may not be sentient, but my goodness, he is terrifying. He has a lot of power. We just don't know it. Alright, let's get... Oh my goodness. Who put these things here? Okay, good. I can feel it from there. Pretty cool. Paint. Hey, monkey, how you doing? House flipping. That's right. We're flipping that house. We actually were supposed to be playing something else tonight. But unfortunately, that didn't end up happening. And I figured, what better way to relax and cool down off of that disappointing scenario than flipping some houses. Just badly painting a bunch of houses. That's been pretty good so far. Can't complain. Well, I can complain. I can always complain. And I do. Okay, put that on. Hello, there we go. Twitch should let people opt to hide their mod badge. It would be like an undercover cop. Nope! There's already enough people that have mod badges. Like, right now, everyone in the stream, everyone in the chat has a mod badge. If half the people were just, like, suddenly not modded, or, like, it didn't show, it would be even more confusing. We should pin the grassroots application at the top of the chat to encourage more peeps. I mean, that's not a terrible idea. Thank you, Adam. Instantly done it. On top of it. The one problem I have with that is not necessarily so much a problem, but it's just that I'm currently... Everything's happened at once, and I'm currently asking people for their financial support. Well, their support for multiple things. So I don't want to be like, go vote for me on this thing. Make sure you come to the anniversary stream. Make sure you're joining in Terraria and Brawlhalla during the anniversary stream. Make sure you've got this. Make sure you're doing that. It's like a big old information overload. But that being said, vote for me in the grassroots program. Maybe I'll become someone important. I won't. Because the fact of the matter is, even if there's more people watching me, I'm still not important. But these green tiles are nice. If you were born in the 70s. Wow. Bombard the masses. Did you not see the, like, veritable essay that I put in Discord about the anniversary stream?
The mani play de Tulog and time. Vote un for arrobas just right wing so we can focus on his happiness.
Yes, so we can focus on his happiness. Thank you, Adam. Thank you. I need to focus on my penis. Happiness. And the grassroots program will help me do that. Help me achieve that, so. The power is in your hands, chat. Will I be happy or will I be miserable? God damn it, now nobody's gonna vote. Why did I say that? Why? That was a dumb thing to say. People are gonna retract their votes now. Suckers, you can't. The votes have been cast, you cannot remove them. Joke's on you. Might be almost time for more coffee. From what I gather from coffee drinkers, it's always time for more coffee. From a former coffee drinker myself, I can confirm that this is true. Can I open this? How am I supposed to get... Am I just supposed to, like, reach over the top? Can I even get that one? Oh, yeah, I can. It's a bit awkward. Oh, can I get that one, though? Oh, yep, I can do it. Believe in the heart of the cards. Got it. I should hopefully have enough tiles for this. Yeah, just enough. I need to take drugs and do ballet. Aaron, you don't need any more drugs. Stop it. Get some help. Just do the ballet. You don't need the drugs. You'll be fine. Oh, was I supposed to do both? Yeah, well. It didn't look like it mattered, so. Let's get a washer. Wait, where did... Where is that mounting? Radiator? Washer. That's the washer there. Oh, this one's way cheaper. Why did I try and give them the actual good washer? What's wrong with me? What? Oh, I need to Oh, okay. Righto. Didn't know that. I should be multitasking, listening to your beautiful voice while doing... By doing pie... Doing... Is that the word that you said the other stream? Piles? Plies? Plies? Is that the word? Do plies for me, please. Plies! Do some plies for me! I'm so funny. It's the only way you're going to get to be doing Swan Lake in the next week. If you're doing all the plies now. Oh! Okay. Easy. Easy. We've done it. We've got it. Maybe installing a washer was really this easy. It's not that much harder, but it is harder. You got it! Yay! I did it, Mom! I'm a professional ballet now. That's how that works, right? And notice the fact that I said, I'm a professional ballet, not ballerina. I am the ballet. I am one with the ballet. And I am professional. As you can tell, because you're watching this stream, question mark? Holy crap, this place is cramped as hell. This must just be like a standard European. Got a washer next to the toilet, next to the shower, next to a radiator, next to the sink. Alright. Turn the light on. Okay, I've done this room, so excuse me, so I can close that. That one's done. This one is done. This is the last room. People go to watch Just Right Gaming, the ballet, not the person. Exactly. Exactly. It's a ballet. It's not ballerino. Ballerino? Says Aaron. I'm not a ballerina. I am a ballet. It's like Swan Lake. I am this just in. I am Swan Lake. Can confirm, I am Swan Lake. Don't fact check me on that, because it's true, and you don't need to know any of the details about it. I am Swan Lake. We not do the windows in here. I knew I forgot the windows somewhere. This was the place. You got ads? Not the ads. Always with the ads. God damn it, Bezos! Oh, so, just a complete gear shift. Is anyone familiar with the new ads? What am I trying to say here? The new way that they were introducing to do ads on the platform, on Twitch, where they would do that little preview thing before you came into a stream. Like, if you came into a stream, instead of being slapped with 5 minutes of pre-rolls instantly, you were supposed to get like 30 seconds of time to actually watch the stream before it was then like, oh, if you'd like to keep watching the stream, please watch these ads to support the streamer, and then you can go on to watch the streamer. Is anyone familiar with that? Because they introduced it it was either last year or at least several months ago, at the very least. And everyone was like, actually, one of the first good things Twitch has come up with in a very long time. Actually, genuinely, a very good idea. And then, like, completely unceremoniously, it was completely disbanded. I don't know if it ever even got out of testing. I remember never actually seeing it, only hearing about it. And then, oh, here's the dirt. And then suddenly it was no more. So they did that, right? Like several months ago. And recently they announced that they're doing it again. Like they're bringing that thing out. So I really hope it actually happens this time, because it's actually genuinely could be really helpful, especially for smaller creators. Because if you go onto Twitch, into the categories, and you start scrolling through streams to try and find someone to watch, if you're like exploring, want to find a new streamer to watch or whatever, or just, you know, kill time for a bit, as soon as you go into a stream and you get hit with those pre-rolls, those like sometimes literally 5 minutes of pre-rolls, you're not going to stick around to see if, oh, maybe I might like that streamer and then be disappointed and leave anyway. You're going to be like, nah, dog, and then just move on to the next one until you find someone that doesn't have pre-rolls. And the amount of, like, piss around it is to try and get the pre-rolls turned off, essentially. Either you end up, like, making no money, which isn't necessarily the end of the world, but it's not just that. It's down to, like, affiliate agreements and all sorts of different things. Or you have to, like, be on top of running those ads manually all the time. And I've said this before on stream a number of occasions. The notification for when it's supposed to tell you that the pre-rolls are going to run out and you're going to have to run manual ads doesn't work. So I don't run them anymore because I never get the notification. And I just gave up. Because there was a period of time where I was trying to actually manually run the ads so that we didn't get pre-rolls. But it just sort of fell apart. So I really hope that they do actually end up doing something with that this time. Because it could genuinely be a very helpful feature. Alright, here we go. Let's buy the family house. Let's go. I think you can probably schedule the ads to be every so many minutes according to when pre-rolls end. I don't think you can schedule the ads. Well, you can schedule the ads, but then that is just the pre-rolls, though. It doesn't remove pre-rolls from, like, when people come into the stream. To remove the pre-rolls from when people enter into the stream originally, you have to manually run an advert. Unless they've massively changed it recently. Because that's always been the experience that I've had. Because pre-rolls are a pain in the ass because everyone just leaves. And like, pretty much any stream you go into, like, it's not even just me. That's why I'm fairly certain that you can't just, like, schedule them like that. Is that, like, if you just go into any category and just try and look at any stream, 90% of them, you're just going to be slapped with, like, at the very least, like, 30 to 40, 50 a minute, you know, of pre-rolls. It's because nobody schedules ads. Well, I would think that if you could do that, because I remember looking into all that sort of stuff originally. What the hell is this room? This is bloody sus. Is this the naughty corner? Interesting. If you could do that, then I'm pretty sure, surely everyone would be doing that because of how bad pre-rolls are. They just choose ad density, I believe. Well, yeah, I know you can choose add density, and I have mine on, like, the one of the lowest densities you can. I have it, like, it's like a minute and a half per hour or something. And I do, like, a between a 2 and a 3 hour stream, so it ends up only hitting a couple times. But unless they changed it, I definitely remember looking through there and not seeing a way to, like, manually change and schedule those to avoid that. Because essentially it's doing... Am I Jesus? Or is this glass? I guess I'm Jesus. Yeah, I remember, like... Because I would, yeah. I would definitely schedule it if I could. Because it's essentially doing the exact same thing. Personally, I've never played around with ad settings, but I have run manual ads. Yeah, no, I'm fairly certain you can, like... Essentially, the options are either you just let it run the pre-rolls when the pre-rolls... Because that's essentially scheduled, right? Like, when the timer ticks down, it runs the next set of ads. That's, like, having the pre-rolls on. Or you can manually run ads to turn that pre-roll off for another X amount of time, depending on... Wow, this is green. Depending on what you chose. Like, how much ads you chose. Like, if it's a minute and a half, it stops it for, like, half an hour or whatever. The longer you do the ads, the more it stops. I was in one stream where I literally got hit with 5 whole minutes of ads. And 4 of them... I think there was like 8... No, there was like 10 ads. And like 5 of them in a row were the same ad. Like, literally the exact same ad. I was just like, come on now. How unreasonable. Oh, I need to realize that I can actually see the dirt on the radar. Pre-roll is specifically the ads that pre-roll when someone first enters the stream, not all ads. Yeah, but I think the terminology is basically interchangeable with the way that it uses them. Because, like, I've literally got a timer up at the moment on my thing that says, like, 21 minutes until pre-rolls. And that counts for people coming into the stream, but also people that are currently in the stream that don't have a sub will also be hit with ads. To be fair, that doesn't seem to always happen. They don't always get hit with ads at that moment, but they do get hit with ads eventually. I don't think so. I think pre-rolls are simply that. Pre-rolls disabled for X minutes. Well, you must have some insider knowledge that no one else has then, because that's definitely how it interacts for me. Let's place those lights. there's something here that I need to fix. What is it? Oh, it's the light switch there. Specifically the ads that play when you enter a stream as a non-sub. Advertisers that appear before live streams are called pre-roll ads. Ads that appear during streams are known as mid-roll ads. But the effect is the same though. If you run the manual ads, it stops pre-rolls and mid-rolls, does it not? Does it only stop pre-rolls now? You don't think so? It may stop mid-rolls. Wait, now you're saying it only stopped mid-rolls? It definitely stopped pre-rolls. That's literally the entire reason you run the ads manually, is to stop pre-rolls. It stops pre-rolls. Okay. Maybe not mid-rolls. Okay.
Golly, you're the best.
Hey, Conkra.
Three months, baby's debut.
3-month baby Stevis. He's growing up to be a big, strong boy. Somebody wanted to stop those mid-roll ads. I really appreciate the sub. I hope you're enjoying your time. And thank you for the tier one. Very much appreciated. Okay, I think I've probably done most of what I'm gonna do for now, because otherwise, is that dirt there? This doesn't look very nice, this bed. I'm just doing like a basic cleaning, and next time we come back around, I'll do a proper revamp. I think I've got everything I need to for now. My point being, there's a reason they use the terminology they do. Pre-roll ads disabled for 50 minutes. Yeah, but my point is, everyone gets hit with pre-rolls quite a lot on Twitch. And the thing that they're supposed to be bringing in, and were supposed to bring in a while ago, but then they randomly canned it, is supposed to get rid of pre-rolls for a preview window of, like, I think it's like 30 seconds, so that people can come in and watch without getting hit with those, so they can experience it before being driven away by the ridiculous amount of ads. So regardless of any of the technicalities, that is the point that I was making, and that is the point that I'll be interested to see what happens, because everyone definitely 100% does get that, unless they're like not an affiliate, like not monetized at all, and like have that turned off. And it would genuinely be a very helpful feature. What am I missing here? Something there. Streamers can now disable pre-roll ads for incoming viewers by regularly running ad breaks during their stream, allowing viewers to immediately see what's going on. Yeah, but it doesn't tell you, like, the alert thing doesn't work properly to tell you when to run them. Is this broken? Maybe that's what I'm replacing. Maybe I have to sell that sink. Oh no, it's like something over here. Yeah, I don't know. Let's just sell all of this. Oh yeah, it's the stuff behind it. Okay. Sell all the cabinetry. We'll deal with that later. Based on this excerpt from Twitch, I think they would specify if they had to manually run ads. I suspect scheduling would achieve the regularly running ad breaks requirement. Confirmed, will ads scheduled with Ads Manager contribute towards disabled pre-rolls? Yes. Scheduled mid-rolls contribute to pre-roll free time in the same way that manually run mid-roll ads do. They must have changed it then. Because, like, I definitely not only just, like, went through that thing with a fine-tooth comb to try and make sure that I could turn off pre-rolls and make sure that I didn't, like, to see if there was a way around manually doing it, and there wasn't an option to do that. And the consensus that I had from everyone else that I talked to was that it ran them itself, or you ran them yourself to disable the pre-roll. It could be new, but this is on their support side. Oh, I might have to look into it again then, because it's genuinely like, it's such a pain in the ass having pre-rolls just turn everyone else away. Because I don't mind as much if people have to deal with a, you know, a few mid rolls here and there, because you guys that are in the stream are either already subscribed, or you know that you want to stick around because you, for some reason, and you will stick around for, like, you know, a few minutes for ads or whatever, or like a short amount of time for ads. And it's not gonna make or break anything, but people that have no idea about the stream yet are gonna be like, nope, ads, bye bye. So I'll obviously have to take another look at that. If they've changed the way that works. Because I don't know how mine's set up at the moment. I know that I made sure to set it up in a way that I could control it as best I could, but there wasn't many options at the time, so I'll have to look at it again. There was a red thing somewhere here.
If you're looking for a shield, Stonewall Shields has a fine selection.
No, it's like not a shield, like a maybe it's like a power socket or something. Some sort of defect. Here it is. It's the other corner. There we go. Power socket. Thank you though. Shields are good, right? What? Oh, it's the windowsill. There, that'll do. Alright, assemble. Put that in. Put that down. There we go. Alright, put it back on. Okay. That will be all that I'll be doing on the house for now. So let's bring that screen back up. Go back to the main menu. Let it save and then quit. Save and exit. There we go. And now that I'm thinking of it and that we've been discussing it, I want to see if I can quickly see if there's anything I can do to change those settings, or like what the settings currently are. What's it even under? Is it under stream setting? No. Affiliate? Is it under affiliate? Oh, that's what I'm trying. So it's ad-free viewing, subscriptions watch with ad-free, yeah. Ignore slow mode. Oh, I didn't know you could do that. Subscribe chat only. The increase revenue, ad revenue share. Beginning in August 2022, affiliates will earn 55% ad revenue split for setting ads manager to 3 minutes or more of ads per hour. That probably makes sense because I set everything up, 2 years ago, I guess. And then I rechecked everything like 1 year ago, which would have been, 1 or 2 months from now that they made the change? So I wouldn't have been familiar with it? So how do you actually do it? Yeah, there's something new in the ads manager, question mark? Setting ads manager to 3 minutes or more of ads per hour. Oh, that's just that thing though. That's not the scheduling thing, right? Oh no, that's the increased revenue share. No, that's something different. That's how you can get a higher revenue share for playing way more ads, which I'm not looking at doing. I want only a minute and a half. Yeah, no, this whole thing is just the scheduled mid-roll. But you're saying that apparently it turned that scheduled mid-roll, they're saying that turns off the pre-roll, does it? Add scheduled with... Ad manager contribute to disable pre-rolls. Yes. So mine is, it's scheduled for 1.5 minutes per hour. I only get a 30% revenue share. Yikes. Upcoming ad break. Yeah, that thing doesn't work. The notification. Yeah, so I've got it. I don't know why you've got like commas in there for some reason, and that's like breaking up the URL for some reason. So this is basically exactly what I was talking about. This is, yeah, it's scheduled. It's basically the exact same thing. This is what, once these run, it theoretically disables pre-rolls, but I swear people still get pre-rolls all the time. So I don't know like when it disables pre-rolls and for how long, because theoretically, by the way that it says it, it should be that you run a minute and a half of ads after an hour. But how long does it actually stop pre-rolls for? Because it doesn't stop it for the whole hour. Yeah, it looks like it stops it for like half an hour? I don't know. Must depend on how long an ad it plays. Yeah, well you can... I've got a minute and a half ads because I don't want people to have like ridiculous amounts of ads in the middle of the stream. But... does that not make the pre-rolls turn off for very long? Because it has a comma in the link and the auto text doesn't like commas. Yeah. Yeah, that's what I thought. When a streamer runs a 30-second ad break, pre-rolls will be disabled for the next 10 minutes. Is that all? Oh, well, 30 seconds, I guess. 1 minute, it's for 20 minutes. Yeah, so 1.5 minutes is for 30 minutes. So I'd need to be running... essentially, I'd need to be running 3 minutes... 3 minute ads every hour, I guess, to disable pre-rolls entirely. This is an interesting dilemma. Chat, people, for everyone that's present right at this moment, we have a decision to make here. Because I had lent on the side of less ads during the mid-roll for the sake of people not having to be slapped by a whole bunch of ads while we're streaming. But that unfortunately seemingly does mean that for more than half of the stream, well, no, I think exactly half of the stream, new people that want to come into the stream are getting slapped with a whole bunch of mid-rolls, which could be a large contributor to the reason why we don't often get many new viewers in, because they must be joining at the times where the mid-rolls have not been recent enough, and they're getting hit with pre-rolls. So, the fix with that would be to jack it all the way to 3 minutes. Not a sex thing. Which means there would be more mid-rolls, more ads for you guys during the stream, longer ads. I would get more ad revenue, which is honestly neither here nor there for me. I don't care. But it would mean that people coming into the stream, in theory, would never have to deal with mid-rolls. And that could be a big boon. What does chat think? If you do 3 minutes per hour, you will disable pre-rolls entirely and get much higher revenue share. Win-win, if you ask me. Yeah. I still don't like the idea of 3-minute ad segments. But there are the other benefits do seem to be pretty decent. I don't think anyone else is here. If your account is accurate, which I doubt. Oh, yikes. you know what? We're all about trialing things. I'm going to trial it. I'm going to make the change right now. I'm assuming it won't take effect. I say do it. Okay. Especially accept terms. Yeah. Especially with the reasoning that I mentioned before to help make this change, that the regulars, you guys, that are here throughout the stream normally, are either already subscribed, so you won't have to deal with the ads, or you know the content is something that you're willing to stick around through for some extra ad time, so that new people will have the chance to actually experience it. That's my reasoning. I don't like the idea of the more ads, and the monetary side of it doesn't factor into it even remotely, because it's not part of the decision. But I do think that having the permanent pre-roll disable could actually quite positively impact the amount of people that come in and actually are able to experience the stream. Because I think, and this is another reason why I think recently, Aaron, we were talking about the fact that I don't think a lot of those numbers, like the unique viewer numbers and stuff like that, are very accurate or mean much at all. And I think that could be a big part of it, is that people come in and then they see they see an ad and then they leave, but it still counts them as a unique viewer. I think that must come into it as well. Going to change mine now as well. Now the alternative is to do 1.5 minute ads every 30 minutes, so it's not giant chunks. Right. Oh, I guess you can do the spacing differently. That could be something. 3 minutes of ads. Think you're onto something? Well, there is the option of doing... That's not a bad... We can either do the 3 minutes of ads all at once and disable pre-rolls indefinitely, or we can have 1.5 minute ads every 30 minutes. What do you think would be more annoying? I genuinely don't know. Would I rather sit through... I think maybe Aaron might be right with the alternative 1.5 minutes every 30 minutes. That might actually be better, because you're getting locked out for a minute and a half, but... excuse me. Getting locked out every 30 minutes, but it's only for a minute and a half. 3 minutes is a long time to be watching ads. We might do that. We'll see how that goes. Well, instead of raising the amount of ads in one chunk to 3 minutes, we'll halve we'll double the frequency. I mean, you can take a piss break with 3 minutes. I mean, this is true. The problem is it doesn't really tell me when ads are running. I'm sure there's probably a way you can make it tell you, but I've not found a way that it can actually tell me that ads are running, so that I could then just be like, okay, I'm going to go take a piss break while everyone else is doing it. But let's test out a minute and a half per 30 minutes. So we'll have twice as many ads, unfortunately. We'll have twice as many ads because we'll be doing it twice as much, but... I missed everything you said. I set mine to 1.5 minutes of ads every 30 minutes. Did you get hit with the... Was that what you said? Was that what you meant? Yeah, the 3 minutes of ads. So you got hit with that? Yeah, I was just discussing that very point. Whether I make it 3 minutes of ads per hour or if I make it 1.5 per hour. It was a bit brutal. Yeah, okay. So I have... So I've changed it. That was a decent suggestion. I didn't realize I could
bloody
change.
Peasant.
Yeah, get a sub, Brian. You won't have any ads. This is how we can make people sub. We just change the ad spacing on the fly and just force the ads, or do manual ads so people are like, oh god damn it, I need to subscribe so I don't have ads. Yeah, I think. Although it's annoying to have that many ads, we're still going to have that many ads anyway, but maybe not in a 3 minute chunk. Having them more frequently would be more palatable. I think having 3 minutes of ads at once can just easily detract new viewers as pre-rolls can, so every 1.5, 30 is ideal in my opinion. Yeah, I think that's what we'll try. I think you might be right. Now that I understand how they work a little bit better, This could definitely help. Unfortunately, like I said, it will mean that we've got twice as many ads as we had before, but it also means that people coming in will never have to deal with those ads until they're sucked in, until they can't leave. Then they will have to deal with ads. And that's fine at that point. They can subscribe and get rid of those ads. Win, 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 win. We'll see how it goes. Twitch is really incentivizing ad revenue. Yeah. It's because they're a platform that makes a loss. Like, they lose a whole bunch of money and they're trying to squeeze every bit of money out of the audience and creators that they can to stabilize, because they're not getting paid by Daddy Bezos, really. So they just try and wring as much money out. And unfortunately, it doesn't help for the creators. It's called Twitch because you get angry at the ads and start twitching. True. I've always been an advocate for ads. I'm fine with ads. It's just the excess of ads with the very minimal diversity of ads. Because on Twitch, you have the same... You have about six ads that play. I think it's regional, but you have like six ads that play over and over and over again. And it just gets so infuriating. Like, I don't mind having ads because it means that we can get things for free. And the sacrifice is to watch ads. I still hate them. They're still bloody annoying, but I much prefer what the end product allows for them being there than them not being there, because otherwise I have to pay for it. Essentially, I have to pay for these things. But it's just the way that Twitch does it, and the way that Twitch is set up, and the way that they're pushing more and more and more, that is so grating to everyone, and everyone hates so much. Then there's AdTube and AdBook and InstaAd. Classic. I hate ads. I won't even download an app with ads anymore. Yeah, I mean, I get it. I do get it. They are bloody frustrating, but I do understand why they're there. And at the end of the day, I do prefer them to be there over the alternative, even though they are so annoying. Ads are what make businesses succeed, and they also are a way for streamers to be supported. Yeah, at the end of the day, without that big ad money, a lot of this just flat out wouldn't be possible at all. So they are unfortunately a necessary evil. It's just the way that Twitch has been doing it is super invasive. Most ads on these platforms are useless. I don't think I've ever been tempted by an ad from Twitch or YouTube. This is the thing though, like, you may not necessarily feel this way, but you're actually in a unique position in that, because people are very susceptible to ads. Like, more than you would think. And it's not, it's usually not in the way that obviously you're responding to them in a negative way. It's not like, oh yeah, I see the ad for that thing, I'm going to buy it. That's not how the ads work. They work in a way that you just, they appear so often and they're just, they're in the back of your mind without you realizing. And then when you eventually get around to looking for a product that happens to be within that realm of things that you, that you've been shown ads for, without realizing, you'll just be like, oh, I've heard that brand before. I've heard that thing before. I've seen that thing before. I'll get that one. Because I've heard of it. I've seen it. I know of it. You don't, but, you know, that's what it does. It subconsciously makes you go, without realizing, towards that thing that has been shown a bunch of times. If the, to be fair, to clarify, if the ad is done, there's a niche to it. There's a certain way to do it, because if it is so grating that people actively hate it straight away and will actively distance themselves from it, which can happen even even for people that aren't are more susceptible to it, then it won't work. But as largely, it's subconscious stuff, not like, oh, I see that ad, I want to act on it. Sometimes I've clicked on Facebook or Instagram ad. Most of these ads become triggers for anger. So when I see the brand, I get angry. Yeah. Yeah, so that's the example of when, obviously, it's not... But for every you there is, like, 300 people that it does work on, probably more. So for them it's a win-win. They don't, because at the end of the day they don't give a damn if you you Mr. DRF in his house where he lives hates their brand, if the other five houses around him will buy from those from them. It makes literally no difference to them. So just pure weight of numbers can get them does get them exactly what they need. Capitalism is death. Can't argue with that. All right. We've hit a lot of hard topics tonight, and I think it's definitely time to wrap up the stream. I am very interested to see how those new changes will go going forward. I'm hoping we see a positive difference now that we've changed that. And luckily for you, Adam, you're the one that would be most annoyed by this change, but you're subbed, so you don't have to deal with it. So it'll be from other people that we'll see what will happen, and hopefully it'll all work out. So ballet? Yeah, ballet. Now that we've covered the big topics, ballet. Classic meme. Classic. It's a new meme, but it checks out. Mainly, the main reason that I'd never changed it before as well, in like the way, other than the fact that I didn't fully understand how the pre-rolls and the mid-rolls actually interacted, and how long they interacted for, I didn't want to like put a whole bunch more ads on, because it's a worse experience, and then have people think, oh well, he just wants all that extra ad revenue share. I don't care about the ad revenue share. It just so happens that by doing that allows the pre-rolls to disappear. And that's all it is. I might see one ad when my Prime runs out to remind me to reactivate it. Well, there you go. That's a perfect little reminder then. See, ads are good. Ads are good. See? He's coming around already. He's not. Let's do a raid. Wait, no. Before I do that, I'm just going to quickly run through the schedule so that everyone knows. I'm sure we all know, but I'm going to run through it anyway just to get everyone on the same page. Tonight was supposed to be Battle Shapers. Unfortunately, it didn't happen. I sent an email to the person that can be in contact with the person that I need to... Hey, Truman, welcome to the end of the stream again. How you doing? I've been in contact with them, so hopefully within the next week, we might get a message back. We may end up getting another code that we can use to actually play the game. Not holding my breath. So it's likely that we'll be back in normal rotation for a little bit. We'll see how we go. So next Wednesday, I'm not exactly sure what I'll do because that usually would be the House Flipper slot without the indie game rotation. That would be the normal one, but we just did it tonight. I don't know if we just do a back-to-back or if we choose something else. It's something I'll figure out by myself. I'm not sure. Tomorrow night, no stream. That is my night off. I'll be watching shows, catching up on things. Still not watching the Starship Troopers movie. And I'll quote it. Not know what I'm quoting when I eventually play that game again. Still not gonna do it. Not because I don't want to, just because I have so many other things. That brings us to Friday, which is, drumroll please, the start of the Borderlands 1 4-player co-stream. That's right, 4 whole streamers. This is 8. 4 whole streamers are going to be playing Borderlands 1. Myself, Aaron, who's in the chat right now, Gremslin, who we are going to be doing a co-stream with for the anniversary stream, but I digress, that's later. And Miss Ruby Gloom. We're going to be starting the... We're going to be starting the Borderlands co-stream this Friday. Super looking forward to it. Insert indie game here. Yeah, just whatever indie game's on the chopping block. Are we doing multi-stream setup? Yes, I've already set up mine. I've got 4 corners and chat. You can set yours up however you like, but that's what I've got mine. I was tempted to do me as the big screen and then you three at the bottom, but I feel like it's more democratic if we're all 4. Doesn't really matter. People can change around as they want anyway. Anyway, Friday, that's what that is. Saturday will be more Mass Effect 3. We're getting pretty... We've gotten a decent way through that now, I think. I think we've still got a fair way to go. This one feels like it's going to be a bit longer, also because we're doing a bunch of the side quests. But I'm actually thoroughly enjoying just experiencing that game because I've not played it before. And it's been super fun. That's Saturday. Sunday night stream as usual. Brings us back to Monday. More XCOM. We're very close to the end of that game, I think. That thing has been... Oh, that's been a roller coaster of emotions. Always super fun, even if we get trawled by sectopods from start to finish. That's been really good for people getting engaged as well. Not to be married. Engaged to me. Not to be married. Engaging with me in conversation. So look forward to that. Tuesday, some more Fallout 3. We are currently... Oh, that's right. We're killing all of the Brotherhood of Steel. Well, we're doing those simulation missions, which are actually super fun. The Battle of Anchorage, I think is what it's called. That DLC. That's actually been real fun. And that brings us back to Wednesday. The only other thing to note, as I've said a number of times, I'm going to say it again, just to drum it in everyone's skulls. Saturday the 8th of July, we are doing a 12-hour live stream for the anniversary, the 2-year anniversary of this mess. We are starting with Terraria. It will go for about 5 hours. I'm co-streaming it with Gremslin. All you guys can play along with me if you have the Steam version of Terraria. We can all play together and there's prizes to give away, free games for the whole thing. There's special ways to do it. It's all in the Discord and it will be said on the day as well. Then we will be having a Brawlhalla tournament. Again, that game is free. It's on Steam. You can get it for free. You can practice. You can download it and free games will be given away depending on where you place in the tournaments. We're also doing just raffles throughout the stream as well. So You will not be able to leave the stream without a game. I will throw one into your chat box, and you will have that code. You can't escape it. And then we will be finishing with some Sims 4. We'll be creating a whole bunch of characters from chat suggestions and probably killing a bunch of civilians. It's going to be wild. I'm looking forward to it. That's like 5 hours at the end. And it goes from 10 a.m. to 10 p.m. Australian Eastern Standard Time. So you've no excuse for missing it. You don't have to be there the whole time, unless you're Adam. But you do have to be there for at least 11 hours. That's, I don't make the rules. I don't think I've ever set it up, had to set it up. I just use your link. Yeah, so that one will just be that. There's a layout that you set up. I can send you my link if you want. It will be the same thing, but it basically, that just says layout 3, but 2 people, and it just puts one person on top, one person on the bottom. But if you go to that same link, basically you can add 4, a whole bunch of different streamers, and then arrange them in different ways.
It isn't a sex thing.
It's not. Pulling guys off is not a sex thing. But yeah, I've got a specific layout. It's just 4 people in chat. Anyway, we really need to wrap up stream. So we're going to raid Quali, I think, if she's still live. Saw that she was live before. She's just chatting, so she's probably going to be live for a bit. So everyone jump in. Go say some... Let's be mean this time. Be a troll. Say that... Why do you look like you're wearing a picnic blanket? Quali? Is there another? I don't know. Just do whatever. Do what you want. I'm not your dad. Thanks everyone for watching. I know most people have already left, if they even joined in the first place. But I will see you guys next week for some more... Well, I don't know yet. We'll see. Otherwise, Friday for the big Borderlands co-stream. See ya!
Shut up, Wesley.
Yeah, Wesley's here? Shut up, Wesley. Ta-ra! Stay fresh, cheese bags. Yeah.